In this bulletin, Queensland begins holding educational forums ahead of a truth-telling and healing inquiry. A warm welcome for Pope Francis in Timor-Leste. And in football, the Socceroos prepare to face Indonesia on the path to qualifying for the 2026 World Cup. With the latest SBS News, I'm Biwa Kwan. Queensland has begun holding educational forums ahead of the launch of its truth-telling and healing inquiry later this month. Some of the first forums were held on Wyben or Thursday Island in the Torres Strait. Wanyi and Kalkadoon man Josh Creamer is the chairperson of the inquiry. He told NITV the inquiry will be seeking to hear the voices of those who haven't been heard before in history.
For us, the role is really looking at the impact of colonisation on Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, hearing the stories, the evidence of Torres Strait Islander people, of events that occurred across this region.
Pope Francis has received a raucous welcome as he arrived in Timor-Leste to celebrate the country's 25th anniversary of the UN-backed referendum that paved the way for independence from Indonesia. The 87-year-old pontiff smiled as he waved at those who gathered to greet him. They were waving Timorese flags and holding umbrellas to shade themselves from the scorching sun. Delivering a speech, Pope Francis applauded the Timorese people for having recovered from their greatest suffering and trial to put Timor-Leste on the path of peaceful development. President Jose Ramos Horta says the Pope's visit is significant and presents an amazing opportunity.
In Timor-Leste, His Holiness is a friend, and his visit reward the people of this country. It is the biggest, the best marketing anyone can aspire to promote the country, to put the country on the tourist map.
Pope Francis arrived in Dili from Papua New Guinea as part of his historic trip through Southeast Asia and Oceania. The United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights is urging countries not to accept Israel's blatant disregard for international law in the occupied Palestinian territories. Addressing the opening of the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva, Walter Turk says the international community is at a fork in the road. He says if the state of human rights in the world continues on its current path, then people are facing a dystopian future. He warns an endless cycle of military escalation and misinformation threatens both humanity and the planet. Condemning Israel's increasing violence in the occupied West Bank and its ongoing aggression in Gaza, Mr. Turk says leaders must uphold the rule of law.
The wider situation of illegality across the occupied Palestinian territory, deriving from Israel's policies and practices, as so clearly spelled out by the International Court of Justice in its advisory opinion in July, must be comprehensively addressed. States must not and cannot accept blatant disregard for international law, including binding decisions of the Security Council and orders of the International Court of Justice, neither in this nor any other situation.
Typhoon Yagi, Asia's most powerful storm this year, has left at least 49 people dead and 22 missing in Vietnam. It made landfall on the country's northeastern coast on Saturday, cutting power to millions of households and companies. The country's weather agency is warning of more floods and landslides. Among the affected is 45-year-old restaurant owner and mother Nguyen Thi Thom, who after COVID invested in renovating her restaurant to welcome tourists with money she borrowed from friends and relatives. She says the extent of the loss is devastating.
I have lost everything. There is nothing left. When I look around, people have also lost all they had, just like me. Even though I am sad, I can't talk about it, because it is not just me who is suffering. I can only try to recover from this.
And to sports in football, Socceroos defender Alessandro Cicati says playing in front of more than 75,000 fans in Indonesia's capital is a welcome challenge. The 20-year-old proved himself to be an emerging star in last Thursday's shock loss to Bahrain. Tonight's crucial FIFA World Cup qualifier against Indonesia will be Cicati's fourth international appearance. He says he isn't daunted by what's anticipated to be a hostile atmosphere in Jakarta.
I think it should be energy to fuel your fire. It should get you going, or at least to myself, it pumps me up, makes me want to even win a bit more to go against these, all these fans who could be cheering against you, just to prove them wrong and to really show them, look, 70,000, you don't make a difference to how I play.
And that's the latest from the SBS Newsroom.